Anyone else still having major buffering issues in chat? Don't know if that one was on my end or Twitch's end. All right. Circle is my confirm key for this game. It's tricky to get the hang of that, right? YouTube seems fine. Thank you, Goomba. I'll keep an eye on Twitter to see if Twitch support announces anything. Okay, thanks, Fraff. Awesome chaos, yeah. You gotta do that back and forth. You remind me of the babe. What babe? The babe with the power. What power? Power of voodoo. Voodoo, you do. Do what? Remind me of the babe. I think we may have ended in the middle of a battle last time. Let me double check and load my state just in case. Oh, I guess not. It looks like we can save using the game. We don't have to use save states for this. Cool. Thank you guys for helping me to test that. All right. This game is split into two phases. There's a strategy phase where you control individual castles and you try to move your units around. And there's a tactics phase where the actual individual battles happen, which is pretty cool. You don't see that very often. The entire game of Brigandine takes place on this map with all these different castles. We're the blue color. All the other colors are dudes we want to kill. So over the course of the game, you're trying to capture all these castles, push territory. Here in this phase now, I want to look around and see who all is manning which castles so I know if I can take it easily or not. There's only two units here, so we should be able to destroy these guys pretty easily. This one's also empty. Can I send two people? How many people do I have here? Yeah, for total. These two can probably kill these guys. I think I have to wait till the next turn to move them around. When it's in strategy here, I'm just determining where I want my units to go. But they're probably going to move too, so the situation I'm seeing right now might not stay the same. We'll see. Yeah, this is pretty similar to Ogre Battle. Another game we're playing on stream. We got this new character. We need to summon some dudes for him. Let's do that real quick. Yeah, so it's a monster summoning game. Each of your teams has a leader, and then they get some monsters they can summon from a preset budget. I think we can do from here. Yeah, so see how, like, as I add them, there's that blue value in the bottom right corner. That's the budget for characters they can have. So characters of a certain strength cost more to add to your team. Let's do some summoning here. I haven't done the N64 one yet. It's on the schedule after we beat the Super Nintendo version. Yeah, March of the Black Queen. You can check out the playthrough so far. I'm like 9 parts into it, about 2 hours per part on YouTube. I've been enjoying it so far. It's a cool game. It, like pretty much any SRPG prior to the PS1, it hasn't aged super well. But it's kind of nice to go back and play it and say, hey, how have games improved on this formula since then? It's as important of a game as it is a good game, I would say. Yeah, right, Chaos? not by intention. I attribute a lot of that to the game not telling the player a lot, and I understand that that's mostly correct in an Ogre Battle 64. Final Fantasy Tactics is a really good game. We did a full playthrough of that on stream. We did the Zodiac, the remake for the PSP on stream. Which, if you ever play Tactics, don't play the PS1 version. Oh my god, you're going to hate your life. Please, please, please play the remake. It improves in so many ways. The game's already has a really crazy, hard-to-follow plot, and the horrific translation in the PS1 version just makes that worse. Level 26. And these guys kicked our ass last time. I don't think we want to dick around with them. We need to keep people defending our castles, though. Let's see. These guys should be good. Level 17, level 13. I'll leave them standing there for now. Yeah, I've had that happen, Serp. I've got all the items to turn a wizard into a lich, but my alignments are just trash. And I mean, I've had Kami guiding me, telling me, "Hey, this is what causes this to happen," but it's still really hard to manage. I think it has really cool, aggressive, innovative ideas. They just needed to iterate once to make it work. Right, Goomba? Yeah. The one exception for me as far as getting into SRPGs has been Valkyria Chronicles. It's a game that is kind of easy to pick up right away. It slowly introduces you to the mechanics. The problem with a lot of these games is they throw the kitchen sink at you in the first act. That's happened in Brigandine, actually. This game's really cool, but the first thing they do is they give you a battle that has like 30 units, and you're like, "Whoa, what am I doing? I don't know what to do. Where am I? Who am I? Who is at this castle? We should check." A lot of really nasty dudes. Let's not mess with that at the moment. Could try sending these people like here, since I'm not defending that castle right now, and there might be dudes. There's some pretty high-level guys here, a lot of high-level guys, that I don't want them to take that castle back. So I'm going to send some peeps. Send you down here. Yep, I'm doing 64 as soon as I beat this one. Keep an eye on the schedule. It's been a while since it's been on the schedule. I try to do it off the normal hours, so like bonus on weekends. So there will likely be extra time. We got to wrap up Silent Hill 2, Albert Odyssey, and Ogre Battle. We need to summon some more things. We need to summon some little guys. We've got to be too many big guys right now. I like the Garms. Named for a dog creature in Norse mythology. See them pretty often in Japanese games. Let's get some 3 Gigascorps to wrap it up. Alright. And then we're going to organize and we're going to put these scorpions we just made into our parties here. Give everyone gets a scorpion. You get a scorpion. You get a scorpion. Bees, bees, bees. Yeah, never played XCOM before. I'm excited to do that. Leon added that as a game to the list. Alright. They're all injured from the previous turn, so I think they have to chill here for a round, and then I can move them next turn, is how I understand that. If they die in battle. There's no permadeath in this, which is good. One of the big barriers to entry for SRPGs for me is permadeath. It freaks me out. It makes me obsess over individual decisions. It makes me feel like I need to save scum all the time. I get it's a cool kind of nostalgic mechanic, but I don't think it's necessary. Yeah, right, Goomba. No hell. We get our Fenrir, Jormungandr. It's the third wheel Loki child, right, Goomba? All right, let's go ahead and execute. Now we're in the attack phase. So now we determine which units we want to send to actually fight dudes. And it looks like the enemy has moved around too, so we have to be kind of careful. This one we could maybe take, mostly low-level units. This one has been significantly bolstered. We saw that there was just one unit here before, and they moved some people here to defend it. So I guess I just have to pick one of these to take. I'm going to take one, and I'll probably go down. I'm going to go down here. So I can send which units I want to send to fight. Send those guys. I think they should be able to take it. It's 2 versus 3, but we have a bit of a level advantage in that castle. This one is not happening. That guy's way too high level for us to dork around with. This guy, let's see who's over here. No. Level 29 Death Knight? It's not happening. We might just have the one attack this turn. Let's see who's at Camelford. Level 3, level 20. Wow. Yeah, there's like 6, 7, 8 units here. We're not doing that. I think this is when it's the last red unit standing. We've killed several of them so far. Alright, let's just do the one attack phase and then see what happens after that. We kind of need some of our better units to get out of being dead. Yeah, right, Yukipo? It makes it really hard for me to enjoy it. Oh man, this is the first time the enemies invaded us. Oh, this is gonna be rough. We can try to hit them as much as we can, but there's a lot of bad guys here. Not for long, Road Bull. Alright, so the game is hex-based, and your characters act as a unit, so everyone that has a 1 next to them is part of a unit. Everyone that has a 2 next to them is part of a unit, everyone with a 3, and so on. You can move them whatever order you want, they have different attacks. Their attacks are actually pretty cleverly organized, such that, like, you get 1 attack if you choose not to move on the turn. Let's hit magic here. Next action will hit and earn extra experience. Restore HP to nearby allies? How many is that? Okay, so as long as he stays with them. I might just stay on the castle. It looks like you get a defense bonus for doing that. Going out and meeting them just doesn't seem to be worth it, you know? I can check to see if any of them have, like, a buff action they can use. Ice Breath. Smooth. Special. Owl Fire. His magic. I guess he could try to throw this at somebody. Let me see how much MP he has, though. I don't want to spend all of it. Yeah, we should let them come to us. We're going to chill here. Very likely we're going to lose this fight because we're massively outclassed by the number of units they have. Yeah, I can hear that, Cosmic. Absolutely. This game's really cool. I was impressed when it got added. It's a lot different than what I expected. If you choose to check this game out, you want to find the Brigandine Grand Edition, it's called. The normal one does not work on an emulator, and your chance of finding an actual copy for the PS1 is pretty low. I usually advise that you purchase a game if you can, you know, give the developer money, but in the case of some of these older, like, PS1 titles, you can't find this game. The only way you're going to get money to anybody is going to be somebody charging, like, $120 on Amazon. I'm gonna keep ending and looking at Kometos. Yeah, we're gonna try to kill what we can. They're gonna take our castle, though. What I'm not yet sure about in this game is, like, what's the, what happens when you game over, essentially, when they capture all your castles? Is it really just a game over and you start the game fresh? It seems pretty reasonable with putting your units back in the main castle, so maybe you can kind of turtle up and defend there and hold people off. Yeah, right, Cosmic Gorin? Everybody's got the backlog from hell. Emulation's not too bad, but like I said, if you can give people money for something, probably should. Do I move them? I think I want to take the benefit of them all being close. I guess I could move them so that they're all within attacking range, still within, let's see, what's the details on how far? Friend and foe. I think I actually have to enemy first with it. Double check the heal radius on Healing Word. Okay, so we can go as far as left of the Hydra, it looks like. Now you'll notice that when we go to move, there's an aura around the leader character. The monsters, if they move too far away from the leader, they get a pretty big stat penalty. It's kind of nice that it's built around the idea that you're keeping your leaders close to each other. Yeah, Virtual Console is cool. I mean, my thought is, if it were trivial for every game company to put every single game on their, you know, PSN, Virtual Console, Xbox Arcade, they should do it. Because I always want to give the developer money when I can. But I understand that it's not that easy. Like, there are resources that go into adding something to your virtual console or your PSN. You also often have to do some special tweaks to it, especially in the case of the Wii U. So it's not going to happen probably for more niche games like Brigandine. Hopefully one of them will get within range. One thing I don't really like about emulators is it's pretty easy to feel tempted to use the save state feature, as they kind of comment on in Undertale. Well, there are some Genesis games that you can still buy on like Virtual Console, especially on the Wii U, as it picked up a lot of Sega's backlog. To Howlfire. Alright, hit both of these guys. Yeah, so all the attacks have ranges. The game is really good, although it does throw the kitchen sink at you at the beginning. It's really easy to go in and inspect everything and understand what it does before you use it, which is an issue with March of the Black Queen Ogre Battle. It's kind of hard to tell what stuff does until it's too late. I would love to hit all of those guys. I don't think you can aid this one. He has to stay put to try to kill the leader. I don't think it's going to happen. We'll try to put all of our effort into it. Enemy having a level advantage on you in this game is not like the end of the world like it is in a lot of other titles. Like that, this guy is what, 25 levels, 27 levels higher than our Hydra, but we were still able to inflict some damage, so there's a decent chance we could kill him if we're smart about it. Probably gonna heal this guy. I don't think any of my monsters are gonna survive the next turn, but we'll see. Should probably send him over. Can't quite get there. Hailfoot. This might be a mistake. Yeah, it's gonna be a mistake. Really hard. Ow. That's okay, we tried. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I occasionally emulate on stream when it's prohibitively expensive for me to get my hands on a used copy of it, but as long as the developer lets me pay for it, I always play the legit version. Dune 2? What was it originally for, Cosmic? I know people kind of make a hobby of doing... Did you hear this about Brazil? Like, I guess the Mega Drive is still really popular there. Like, it's so popular that they are making demakes of modern games for it to this day. So there's like a Guitar Hero game for the Mega Drive. That's really popular in Brazil. Pretty crazy. It's really, really hard if I remember it correctly. Yeah. Goodbye. Okada, are you in Brazil? I saw this on a Reddit thread, so take it with a grain of salt if that's not true. Help educate me. Ah, I see. Sure, sure. Well, thank you for cleaning that up for me. I had no idea. I think I read about it last night. It was like some thrown away comment thread talking about how the fact that Mega Drives are still being created there, at least, like, you can still go to a factory and get one. Okay. Ice Breath, this again. Don't know if we're going to get to kill the Death Knight, but... try really hard to make it happen. Could... let's do a big heal here. Oh, hey Ben. Cat is here to say hello. Cat hype there in the bottom right corner. Heal everybody. Shame it doesn't hit the vampire over there and do damage to him, right? I'm guessing for all the times it would be beneficial to have healing affect the enemy too. It would be not beneficial to you most of the time, so that makes sense. I can't move him in range of the death knight, so we're gonna try the maximum number of people we can get. This is the one that is likely to be closer to death if we hit them. Meow. Hey Ben. So soft and furry. Schedule update, guys. We're playing Brigandine until 2 o'clock, so another 37 minutes. And we're switching to Xenosaga Episode 1, which is Yukubo's sub-block game. At 3 o'clock, we're going to do Valkyria Chronicles, which is an SRPG that's set in like a fantasy alternate history. It's like historical fantasy for World War II. And it's a really neat game. If you've ever played an SRPG before and you haven't seen Valkyria Chronicles, I'd tune in for it. Kind of neat to see how it plays. It feels like one of the first modern iterations of the genre that I've really seen. And one of the only ones that doesn't stress me out really badly. Other games coming up. Tomorrow, Saturday, we're doing some Final Fantasy XIV main story. It's the MMO. I'm trying to beat it. It counts as a beatable game. And next week, we're going to see some more Zelda, Phantom Hourglass, some more Metroid. Maybe some Earthbound Beginnings. Let's see. Hey, Debbie Cat. How you doing? Don't know if my Hydra's going to survive this round. Very possibly not. Let's see what the Death Knight is doing. He gets to heal himself maybe every return, which doesn't help. Debbie Cat's really cool. You should check out her Twitch channel, twitch.tv/Debbie_cat. Got her playing Woodmaker a couple weeks ago. She does creative work. Missions for streamers, that sort of thing. Doing alright. Good Friday. Had a really productive playthrough of Undertale yesterday, which if you haven't played yet on stream, I think this is the time to do it, Debbie. It's a really hardcore fan base for that game. It's very short. It's on the order of like 6 to 10 hours. And, people really like to see blind playthroughs. It's like almost like currency you can deal in whether you're providing a blind playthrough of it. Yeah, right? Licensing fees are rough. I find that if your sentence ever begins, not just in video games, but for anything, if your sentence begins with "why don't they just," it's probably a bit of an oversimplification of the situation. It's a lot harder to license stuff than it seems, for example. Well, try killing... I can't use my crossbow anymore, so we're definitely going to lose our castle next turn. This was the first time an enemy's attacked us on our turn. Ben? Debbie, have you played Earthbound before? Really, Kata? So you kind of had like a delay on that front? That's interesting. I wonder if Sega would have died if it hadn't have been for Final Fantasy being on the ESX. Like, what were the other major system movers? Like, clearly it wasn't just Final Fantasy VII and beyond, but I don't know if people were buying PlayStations for Crash Bandicoot. I'm trying to stave off death for as long as possible here. You probably really dig Earthbound. That's another good one, Debbie. A good one to play as a small streamer because it's a moderately niche game, but its viewer base is really, really into Earthbound. Really into Undertale, and that's kind of what you want. Yeah. Anyway, if you're looking for a game to play, it could be fun to check out. They're also pretty easy to pick up. Undertale's $10 on Steam. Earthbound is like $8 on the Wii Virtual Console. Oh, yes, Ben. Cat over here. Let's see. Cool, Goomba. Yeah, it's worth it. Oh, Goomba, you should get on it, man. I mean, it's clearly hyperbole tinged with nostalgia that leads me to say Earthbound is the best game ever. It's not the best game ever, but it is a really, really good game. It's funny. It's got some really cool JRPG features that we haven't really seen in games since then. Oh, Wonder Boy 5. Man. Interesting. I forgot that the Wonder Boy series turned into RPGs at one point. In America, they call Wonder Boy Adventure Island. Kata, did you guys ever have the TurboGrafx-16? In Japan, like, the battle was never really between Nintendo and Sega. It was Nintendo and Hudson with their TurboGrafx system. And I never had a TurboGrafx growing up. I didn't even know it existed. I had a friend after high school who had one and was really into it and showed me a bunch of the games from it. Like Bomberman is a TurboGrafx native title that got ported to other systems later. You're so dead. Can we at least do some damage? Be great to kill her, but that's not going to happen. This is the one we're most likely to kill after a couple turns. Oh, yeah, yeah. If you like Mother 3, I like Earthbound a little bit more than Mother 3. Mother 3 is really good, but it doesn't feel as concise of a story. Like, kind of, it speeds up a little too fast in the third act. Yeah, 3DO frustrations. What all? What failed consoles did you own, or did you know people that owned? I never had a Jaguar. I never had a 3DO. I never had a Lynx or an N-Gage. I had a Sega CD and a Sega 32X is probably the worst console I ever owned. It was one of those where like my parents saved up and bought it for me for Christmas, and then like a couple weeks later, Sega announced that they weren't going to continue supporting it. I tried to return it. Sell it back to Toys R Us, and Toys R Us offered them like $5 for it. It's cool. Heck yeah, it is, Cosmic. You can pick that up on the Wii U Virtual Console. Bomberman 94. Probably the best version of it. Yeah, Dragon Quest 7 and 8 for 3DS are going to be cool. I'll probably do launch day plays of those games. As a smaller streamer, I have to be careful playing launch day titles, especially if they're really huge, like Fallout 4. Just because I'll be playing for a long time and probably not have anybody pop in. But I can make an exception for the 3DS because I happen to have a 3DS capture card and not a lot of folks do. So take advantage of that niche. Doesn't mean I don't want to play those games eventually. I want to play Fallout 4 on stream. I just got to let it filter through the ranks a little bit. Atari, Genesis, Saturn, and 3DS. That's a pretty good progression, Kata. Late May, early June for Dragon Quest VII. That would be nice. You'll probably play that at midnight. The only Dragon Quest game I've played, like, seriously, is Dragon Quest VIII. I played with a couple of the earlier Dragon Warrior games, but never beat them. Play both of these guys. There's three of them. Charlene. I'm just a woman, I get hurt. I'm a knight first. Oh man, yeah. In the US, it's becoming pretty common in like gentrified areas in particular for there to be arcade bars. It'll just be a bar where they have a whole bunch of arcade machines and they're all set to free play, so you don't have to use any quarters on them. They just expect you'll go there and hang out and spend your money on drinks. So if you don't really drink like me, you just want to play video games for free. Works out pretty well. Let's bring some drinking friends with you. Let's move him as far forward as we can. I think we want to attack on the defensive now and then. dragon is best when it starts its turn and gets to breathe without having to move at the same time, so we want to have it move as far forward as we can. Simpsons Arcade, yeah, so Simpsons Arcade, Ninja Turtles, especially Turtles in Time, and the X-Men arcade game are probably the three coolest like multiplayer arcade cabinets. Nice, Chaos. Yeah, we had one called 16-bit in Columbus that got installed right after I left. Right, Goomba? Yeah, just keep playing Chrono Trigger. Exactly, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. Chrono Trigger is such a good game. Talked about that on stream before. It holds up as one of the best RPGs ever. Very modern for the year that it was released. Let's remove our new purple scorpion forward. This guy's leveled up enough times you're able to class him up. I do like games that let you class up your characters. I think it's a Konami issue, Cosmic. Like, it sucks because Konami is like the one of two really amazing third-party developers from way back in the day, early gaming for like the NES and the Genesis. And Capcom has let a lot of their good talent go. They're still making good games, and they still work with companies and make good stuff, but Konami's basically dead. They've announced they're doing mobile games only. Nice crit, dragon. Yeah, one of my dreams, when Andrea and I, my wife, we buy a house together, I would love to buy an arcade cabinet. You can get them pretty cheaply, actually, if you go on like Craigslist, like on the order of a couple hundred bucks. Moving them is a pain in the ass, though. I don't recommend it. I've moved one before. Anyway, I want to get one. I want to gut it. I want to install a really cheap PC inside of it and then put a MAME emulator on the PC. So MAME is the arcade emulator, so it can play every possible arcade game. To do that, you want to try to buy a cabinet that has the maximum number of buttons, so you can do as much of it as possible. It would really be nice if those guys were lined up for my breath, but they're not. What is this guy? What can he do? Pre-move only. 25% stun. Well, I kind of want to kill the leader. Focus her down. I could do that. Okay, let's start doing that. Not gonna get the multiple hits. Oh, because it's on a diagonal, we can't. Interesting. What can they move to? One square? Okay. How about you? Use your magic. Toughen the skin to raise defense. Blurs the mind to prevent casting. What magics does she have? None. Okay. I think I'm gonna raise the defense then of this guy. Gyms? Really? Donkey Kong Country, really? Dude, I remember playing. I have this, like, if you've seen the movie Inside Out, I have the core memory of me playing Donkey Kong Country and thinking, this is it. This is the best graphics will ever be. This is the most amazing anything has ever been. It's never going to look better than this. Non stun! Ooh, no stun. Lazy mist. Oh, that's right, he can move and then move back. That's kind of cool. It's his class feature as a monk, I think. Terror Jaw. Yes! Ouch. I didn't play a lot of Resident Evil back in the day just because... Wait, is this friend info? Before I cast it. It is friend info. That's not great. We don't want that. Although we can get him in range to just regularly attack him. Thank you, HDL. Yeah, Undertale was enormous success yesterday. Yeah. Weird. It's like way back in the day when, Nintendo was into, like, love hotels that charge by the hour. I Ah, gotcha, Kata. Yeah. Yeah, I remember we had Sega commercials in the U.S. talking about blast processing. Sega does what Nintendo don't. Was the line. Heal? We probably want to heal. Do the dragon. I don't know how much it heals for, though. Probably stand to survive another turn without doing that. What's your other skill? Now let's use this guy. This is one of our higher level units. Death Stab. I like death. I like stabbing. Yeah. Scooter. Probably can't get either any of the rest of them into range of that character. We need to kill that mage. They have a AoE attack that can be really dangerous if we're not careful. I think I think this thing has a heal. I'd rather get the golem in there to attack, so. If I do that, who am I gonna do it with? I should heal the dragon. Let me check the range on the heal real quick here. Oh, that's reasonable. Trying to help with the upcoming AoE from the enemy mage. I probably need to start focusing down. Oh, I can't cast heal if I move. Lame sauce. Alright, well, you go ahead and do it. Yeah, exactly, Kata. They were over-innervating. They weren't, like, sticking to a console. They put out the Sega CD, 32X, Saturn, and Dreamcast in, like, rapid succession. People couldn't keep up. It's the same reason why rhythm games died. People just got tired of more and more games that had all these plastic instruments they had to buy. And blame Activision for it. Yeah. Yeah, Dreamcast had a lot of really good ideas. It was a really good system. It's a bummer. Let's get him out of AoE range and go around next turn. See what they do now. Goomba. Cloud's OP, you better root Greninja. Alright, taking poison damage. Not quite enough to be dead, but hopefully she attacks one of us. Ah, lame. Is that a cure spell or is it removing? It's a cure spell. Shit. I wanted to try to kill her before that, but such luck. I don't know if poison can kill or not. There are some games where it doesn't. No, the 32X was not a good idea. There are a couple cool games for it. There was a Sonic game that was pretty good. Double heal? Man. I got a list of things I ain't trying here, and that's pretty high on it. Yeah. Nice miss. Is he petrified? He must be. I think that's what happened. I don't know how petrification works. Status solid. Huh. Do I have something that removes that? I don't know if I do. Right, let's look at what her stuff does. Let's go back. Sorry. Raise defense, blurs the mind, prevent casting. Any of my units have the ability to heal that? Probably not. Let's try using a Ice Breath here. Mega Man. I guess Petrify has the advantage that it doesn't screw over all your other units. Is this friend and foe? It probably is, isn't it? Friend and foe, yeah. Get some decent damage on these guys. I Try having her attack, actually. She actually does decent damage. It does like a... It says stick tap. Oh, wait. Why did... Maybe she only counterattacks that lightning thing she did last time? Huh. Should have had her heal instead. This could be bad. This mage could come and just blow us away here. What are you casting, buddy? Ow. Okay, I cast it on my stoned guy. That's alright. Do worse things. Scorpion be scorpion. Ain't happening. Playing Brigandine for another 17 minutes or so, and then we're switching to Xenosaga for the PS2. After which it's Valkyria Chronicles. Alright, what do you got for healing? Blessing recovers HP. Who needs HP the most? Mostly Fall. Fawn can use it. Figure out who's getting the most healing out of the enemies. I think I'm gonna go with... I'm gonna have Scalber attack her again, and then I'll heal it. Nice critical. Yeah. Yeah, I'm probably going to do that, Mega Man. Don't think I can kill her this turn. I think that all the other units are going to try healing her again next turn. Yeah. Could try seeing. I think I can reverse a move if it doesn't do what I want it to do. Yeah. So I can't get anybody close enough. Cleanse. Removes negative effects. That's the one I want. Asuna, basically. Alright. Good use. Oh, right. Still have this guy hanging out. Can't get him... So we're gonna try stabbing the scorpion just to have something to do. I think that the leader we're trying to kill, isn't it? Get some more heals next turn, unfortunately. Yeah, we kind of got hosed by having our monk petrified last turn. That was good. Looks like all the poison damage happened simultaneously at the start of a turn. Another heal over here, I'm guessing. She basically gets healed to full each turn. It's pretty bad. We can just kill her, all of her monsters run away. Ouch. Your monsters do permadeye, but as you saw earlier, it's easy to respawn them. So it's like you're kind of developing your own units. You spawn them at level 1, and then you try to level them up as much as possible. And then they get to a higher level, now you're interested in keeping them around. But there's not, like... The unique units, the leaders, can't permadie. They get sent back to the base. Stun! And this guy's never gonna get to do anything. let's see. We need to attack her. Missed. He missed some sauces. I think we're gonna get overrun here soon. Mostly because the enemy was focused on healing, we were down by one. Subscriber's choice is usually once per week, SERP. We just do, like I said, a random drawing. Try not to have it take up the whole day. Bye, Dillard, and bye all of your units. Yeah, I might look into fitting it in off normal hours, because I'm going to be paring down the stream to 4 hours a day starting next week. So that sub-block isn't eating too much into the precious scheduled time, I might try to find a day where I can stream for an extra 2 hours to do that. I have to figure out what's going on with the new job I'm looking for. Let's see. Maybe we could do Mondays. Still have some folks who could heal. Keep trying to hit Shireen. More people even get to her now, actually. Try to crowd her. Okay. Unicorn can't get there. But Lizard Man should be able to. Yeah, it's tough trying to focus down the healers, because, like, if you're able to focus down the leader, it's usually really good, because it makes all of their units disappear, including all of their healers, so... You can go in both directions, try to kill the enemy first, start with her. She should, if she's able to die from poison, she will next turn, but I'm going to make 100% sure that that's not an issue by having a scorpion attacker. I think that should do it. As long as it doesn't miss. Death stab. Hey, Scald, how you doing? Yeah, so those units are dead in the water. Even though they're still standing here, notice how they don't have a number. They can't act if their leader's not around. So if we're able to win this fight, which I don't think we will, but if we are able to win, they will possibly join our party. Like, we'll recruit them, take their levels and everything. Actually a pretty good deal. Yeah, recover. Comparable amount of hit points they'd recover. He's poisoned, so we'll kill him up. Do enemy leaders respawn? Does anyone know? If they do, the way that it works is if they respawn in the furthest away enemy castle, and it takes them an entire round for them to be usable again. So the idea is you want to push while they're stuck respawning. Later, Dio. Thanks for hanging out. See you next time. But I healed the Lizard Man. Ouch. He's not using heals. That scorpion could possibly die. Fortunately, their mage doesn't seem to be the smartest character. Don't turn my unicorn to stone! Please, there we go. Scorpion riding a unicorn? That sounds pretty badass. I wonder if there's a Lisa Frank, like, trapper keeper I can get that has that on it. Bubble! I thought this squad already got to go. It was good timing. I think that's gonna kill Lizard Man. Yeah. Bye, Lizard Man. Your life was short. Okay, how my character's doing? Try focusing down the Pyromancer. What are the units looking like? 381, 397. Scorpion's gonna die. Golem's still almost full on health. Oh, he can't. Okay, so we may as well descend it into suicide. Come on, horn stab. 6 damage. He missed. Death stab! Yeah, you, like, overthrow that nation, basically, Mega Man. It's kind of cool. I can't get the golem close enough to do any damage. I don't know if I want to stack them all up in front of the mage. What am I going to do? Put them down and start attacking the angel. Just draw its fire, if nothing else. Yeah, we have to be lucky. It's pretty rough. We've got 4 units left. She's out of MP. We'll see what they do on their next turn. I think certain units are better on the counter than they are on their own turn. Like, unicorns are kind of useless if they try to attack themselves, but... Okay, hopefully she doesn't get petrified here. No petrification. Age of Wonders, what kind of game is that? Running her away, but I don't think it's gonna happen. They're gonna beat here. Who are you flame to death? Just the unicorn? Okay, that's not too bad. That's not so bad. It could have been much worse. 43. Okay. That's a number. Wish there was an easy way to recover MP in this. I don't think there is anything you can do. Yeah, look, the one unit retreated, so we can try focusing down the mage here. I don't know what's gonna happen, though. He only has one unit. Oh, I guess he's got the golem as well. Hey, Ninten, how you doing? Ninten was hanging out in, Haunted stream last night, playing Undertale. Get MP back. Should just go, like, try to stand next to the cleric. Body block. She's probably out of MP too, right? Yeah. Try moving her somewhere as far away as I can. Still think next turn we're pretty much doomed. Try to body block here. Haven't slept yet? Oh geez, Ninten. Alright. So, the scorpion died from poison. Looks like we don't get any XP when that happens. Our golem is successfully body blocking. We'll see what the mage tries to do here. Our success or failure is going to depend really highly on what the mage does this turn. That's okay. That's okay. Could be much worse. What game is it, Ninten? Yeah, next turn we could maybe kill that guy. If our golem can survive. I'm gonna keep having her run, though. Gonna wait here. Project X Zone, what kind of game is it? Is it like an RPG? That wasn't good. Alright, so it's all on our golem to survive to the next turn now. Which might not happen with the mage getting ready to come punch him. Unless the mage has already spent all his MP, but I don't think we're that lucky. Retreat. Hey, look at that. I think we kind of deserve the credit for that one. The enemy units retreated because we damaged them so much, but that was really bad. A lot of our units came very close to dying. I guess we caught a giant and an angel that has a heal spell, so it's not the end of the world, but that was a really hard won castle. Interesting. Bring both of our units here. This is still going to be rough. I think they've got more units than we do, and they're stronger than us. This is the first turn where we've experienced being invaded by the enemy. Shogun we probably want to kill as soon as possible. Let's see, can I get everybody sacked? Is there a mage down here? I have to worry about a mage. There's one. Druid. What's their skills? Whoa, they got lots of skills, including an AoE fire attack, okay. Can stay hanging out here. Energy. Whoa, movement range in this guy is pretty awesome. Since we're on the defensive, I think we kind of want to stay at our castle. We get bonuses for hanging out here. Block the griffin, okay. It's pretty cool, Nintendo. Yeah, you Kapo. Actually, it's about time. I don't think I'm able to get much done in about 2 minutes, but it will take me about 2 minutes to get Xenosaga booted up. I have to switch my capture card, so I'm gonna go ahead and save. And Brigandine will return next time it comes up in the sub-block. It's also available for permanent voting on the spreadsheet if you like this game and want to see more of it. I think the command is !game17 to vote. I'll be back in 2 minutes, so just gotta go get my capture card set up. I'll leave this running in the meantime.